See page number 48. On 48, the passage, second passage, Mabel's got a new dress. He said, and the poor fly was absolutely sure in the middle of the saucer. Really, he would like her to drown. She believed he had no hurt, no fundamental kindness, only a winner of friendliness. Means in the passage, the character Miss Milan and Mabel, the passage, in the particular passage, meeting of Miss Milan and Mabel is going on, and in Mabel's opinion, Milan is very good character because she gives real opinion about her dress. See the third passage. Then Mrs. Holman. Holman is another character. In the passage, see that then Mrs. Holman. The passage depicts meeting between Miss Mabel and Mrs. Holman. Seeing her standing there, bored down upon her, of course a thing like a dress was beneath Mrs. Holman's notice, with her family always trembling downstairs or having the scarlet fever. Could Mabel tell her if Elmothrope was ever late for August or and September? Oh, it was a conversation that bored her unutterably. Since in the particular passage, the meeting is or dialogue is going on between Mabel, Mrs. Mabel and Mrs. Holman. Holman is hungry for sympathy, but she could not never get enough sympathy, and she snatched what little there was greedily. In the particular passage, the description of the character Mrs. Holman is there, and I will read the particular quotation that Mrs. Holman was leaning forward and telling her how her eldest boy had strained his her training. Mrs. Holman is telling about her small children, like her eldest boy and her eldest boy's behavior, gesture, movements, and like this. And the question is, so impossible to keep boys quiet, that was the kind of thing one said. And Mrs. Holman, who could never get enough sympathy and snatch what little there was greedy. Means the whole passage is related with dialogue between Holman and Mabel. The passage depicts the meeting between Mrs. Mabel and Mrs. Holman. Mrs. Holman, who is hungry for sympathy, but she could never get enough sympathy, and she snatched what little there was greedily. Mrs. Holman telling Mabel about her eldest boy and her over his running detachment in the looking glass. But Mrs. Holman, who could never get enough sympathy, she tells about the girl with the swelling joints, used words like cormorants, means large diving seabirds. See page number 49, third passage. But in her yellow dress tonight, she could not wring
out one drop more. She wanted it all for herself. She knew. She kept on looking into the glass, dipping into that dreadfully showing of blue pool that she was condemned. Despite means scorn, means hated, left like this in a backwater, because of her being like this, a feeble, vacillating creature, and it seemed to her that the yellow dress was a penance which had deserved, and if she had been dressed like Rose Shaw in Lovely, clinging green with a ruffle of swans down, she would have deserved that, and she thought that there was no escape for her, none whatsoever. But it was not her fault altogether. After all, it was being one of a family of 10. Never having money enough, always skimping. Skimping means expending very little or less than necessary. And paying, and her mother carrying great cans and the linoleum worn on the stair edges, and one sordid little domestic tragedy after another, nothing catastrophic, the ship far failing, but not utterly. Her eldest brother marrying beneath him, but not very much. There was no romance, nothing extreme about them all. Means in the passage, Mabel tells her economic background, where she had been one of the 10 children. Her economic condition was very poor. Her mother carrying great cans. This indicated probably that she could not choose a dress suitable for such a party, as she could not afford it. It is her domestic tragedy, but she always had a dream of marrying a hero like Sir Henry Lawrence, who was a British military officer, surveyor, administrator, and statesman in British India. Means in the particular passage, the whole description of Mabel's and her domestic condition, her family background being very poor, and see the last part of this passage, means I will read on page number 51. The other night in bed, for instance, or down by the sea on the sand in the sun at Easter. Easter, the most important festival of the Christian church, celebrating the Jesus Christ. Means in the last part of this passage, she is worrying about the sun at Easter. Her recording, she describes Sunday lunch, again goddesses like this. In the particular passage, Mabel tells her economic background, where she had been one of the 10 children. Her economic condition was very poor. Her mother carrying great cans. This indicated probably that she could not choose a dress suitable for such a party, as she could not afford it. It is her domestic tragedy, but she always had a dream of marrying a hero like Sir Henry Lawrence. Henry Lawrence, who was a British military officer, surveyor, or administrator and statesman in British India. British India means we are in Britishers' rule. That time, that position, or that the year, or that the period is called British India. But she had married Herbert with his safe
permanent underlying job in the law court. They managed tolerably in a smallish house. After that, she tells her brother's story, his picture of wedding. Mabel Waring left alone on the blue sofa, punching the cushion in order to look occupied, for she would not join Charles, but enrolled Shaw, chattering like magpies and perhaps laughing at her by the fireplace. Now and then, there did come to her delicious moments. Reading the other night in bed, for instance, or down by the sea on the sand, in the sun, at Easter, her recall it, she described Sunday lunch like goddesses and other things.
See page number 51, second passage. Her richer self again, no doubt. She had always been a fretful, weak, unsatisfactory mother, or only wife, loading about in a kind of twilight existence with nothing very clear or very bold, or more one thing than another. Like all her brothers and sisters, except perhaps her brother. They were all the same poor water-brained creatures who did nothing. Then in the midst of this creeping, crawling life, suddenly she was on the crest of a wheel. That Richard Fly, where had she read the story that kept coming into her mind about the fly and the saucer? Struggled out. Yes, she had those moments. But not that, she was empty, that they might come more and more seldom. By degrees, she would cease to struggle anymore, but that was deplorable, that was not to be endured, that made her feel ashamed of herself. See last paragraph on page number 51. She would go to the London Library, an independent leading library in London, established in 1841 by Thomas Carlyle. She would find some wonderful, helpful, astonishing book, called by chance, a book by a clergyman, by an American, no one had ever heard of, or she would walk down the Strand. Strand means narrow street at the edge of the sea, lake or large river, and drop accidentally into a hall where a miner was telling about the life in the pit, and suddenly she would become a new person. She would be absolutely transformed. She would wear a uniform. She would be called Sister Somebody. She would never give a thought to clocks again, and forever. After she would be perfectly clear about Charles Burt and Miss Milan and this room and that room. And it would be always, day after day, as if she were lying in the sun or carving the button, it would be it. So she got up from the blue sofa, and the yellow button in the looking glass got up too. And she waved her hand to Charles and Rose to show them she did not depend on them one scrap. And the yellow button moved out of the looking glass, and all the spears were gathered into her breast as she walked towards Mrs. Donway and said, "Good night." "But it's too early to go," said Mrs. Donway, who was always so charming. "I am afraid I must," said Mabel Waring, but she added in her weak, wobbly means unsteady, we call it shaky, voice, which only sounded ridiculous when she tried to stain the meat. I have enjoyed myself enormously. I have enjoyed myself, she said to Miss Dolly, whom she met on the stairs. Lies, she said to herself, going downstairs and right in the saucer. She said to herself as she thanked Mrs. Bennet for helping her and wrapped herself round and round and round in the Chinese clock. She had worn these 20 years.
In the last passage, Wolf wanted to tell Mabel's state of mind. She had always been a fretful, weak, unsatisfactory mother, an ugly wife. She tells about her brothers, about her sisters and family background. She decided to go to London library to find some books that could help her transform herself to a new individual. After that, she would not give chance to others to think about her dress again. So as she was dependent on bookish or small knowledge of fashion, her poor economic background could not be blamed for her disappointment. Miss Mabel walked Mrs. Dalloway and said good night, but Dalloway insisted to do not leave the party. Mabel said, I am afraid I must. I have enjoyed myself. Lastly, she utters lies to herself, going downstairs. She said to herself as she thanked Mrs. Bennet for helping her and wrapped herself round and round and round in the Chinese clock. She had worn these 20 years.